Hello, my name is Mike. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to register a source system into Oracle Accounting Hub Cloud. In this example, we'll register a personal loan subledger for mortgages. The Personal Loan Mortgages source system will receive mortgage transactions. There are two types of mortgages, fixed and adjustable rates. Transaction details are used by both types. The adjustable rate mortgage has an additional transaction detail. Loan interest adjusted. Let's begin by navigating to the Setup and Maintenance work area. We'll navigate to the Fusion Accounting Hub offering, select the Accounting Transformation functional area, and then click on the Create Subledger Application Setups in Spreadsheet task. Let's select Download Setup Template and save the spreadsheet locally. Now open the spreadsheet. During the initial design and implementation, the implementation team will populate the spreadsheet after performing an analysis on the transaction, accounting, and reporting requirements. The Instructions tab provides instructions for populating and validating the spreadsheet, as well as generating the zip file. For the sake of time, I've pre-populated the data. Let's take a look. On all of these worksheets, required rows are highlighted. On the Source System Transaction worksheet, I've defined the name and short name for the source system. I've also defined the transaction types. On the Transaction Information worksheet, you'll enter the transaction information that can be used for accounting. These are header-level sources in the application. Note, there are three rows of mandatory sources. The Transaction Line Information worksheet lists the type of transaction information that can have more than one value per transaction, such as a loan rate. These are also known as line-level sources in the application. Note that this worksheet also has three rows of mandatory sources. If the Chart of Accounts value is selected as Yes, you can choose to pass the account combination identifier with the numeric data type and the Chart of Accounts segment values with the alphanumeric data type. After the data is entered on all of the worksheets, it's time to validate the spreadsheet data. We have a confirmation that validation completed. Now we can generate the zip file that we'll upload into the application. We receive a notification that the zip file was created and saved in the same local folder as our downloaded file. We'll return to the application to upload the setup file. From the Create Subledger Application Setups in Spreadsheet page, I'll click Upload Setup File. We'll browse for the zip file we created. Let's import the file now. Our upload completed without error. After successful upload, you can choose to download a transaction template using the Download Template button or download it from the Manage Subledger Application page, also using the Download Template button. Let's review the new subledger we created through the spreadsheet import. First, we must update the selected scope to our new Personal Loan Mortgages subledger. Then, we'll search for the Personal Loan Mortgages subledger application. Here's the new subledger application that we created and the details of the event model. Let's expand the event model. We'll also navigate to Manage Sources. Now let's review the generated sources. Finally, we'll navigate to Manage Accounting Attributes. These accounting attributes are assigned to the sources uploaded from the spreadsheet. You can add additional assignments as needed. For example, if you want the Accounting Hub to calculate the accounted amount, you can map sources to the Currency Conversion Accounting attribute in this task. And that's it. Thank you for watching.